Our mission was called a successful failure, in that we returned safely but never made it to the moon. In the following months, it was determined that a damaged coil built inside the oxygen tank sparked during our cryostir and caused the explosion that crippled the Odyssey. It was a minor defect that occurred 2 years before I was even named the flight's commander. Fred Hayes was going back to the moon on Apollo 18, but his mission was canceled because of budget cuts. He never flew in space again. Nor did Jack Swigert, who left the astronaut corps and was elected to Congress from the state of Colorado. But he died of cancer before he was able to take office. Ken Mattingly orbited the moon as command module pilot of Apollo 16 and flew the space shuttle, having never gotten the measles. Gene Kranz retired as director of flight operations just not long ago, and many other members of Mission Control have gone on to other things, but some are still there. And as for me, the 7 extraordinary days of Apollo 13 were my last in space. I watched other men walk on the moon and return safely, all from the confines of Mission Control and our house in Houston. I sometimes catch myself looking up at the moon, remembering the changes of fortune in our long voyage, thinking of the thousands of people who worked to bring the three of us home. I look up at the moon and wonder, when will we be going back? And who will that be?